Hello, my name is Jeff Schley, Construction Coordinator for the Greater Green Bay Habitat for Humanity. The video you're about to watch describes the partnership between Habitat for Humanity and the DePere High School's construction program. In November of 2012, myself, Habitat volunteer Jim Maynor, seven DePere High School construction students, and their teacher Aaron built a home on East Alloway Avenue. This is the story of our experience.
What I'd like to speak to is the real world lessons that I think the students are really getting. And what I mean by that is not only are they getting skills from the hands-on portion of the course, but what's being instilled in them is work ethic, responsibility, accountability, the real world consequences for their actions. And what I mean by that is that when the students make a mistake, you know, in the classroom, on a worksheet or something like that, they can redo it, they can kind of turn it in late or whatever the case may be. Out here, there's consequences for that. They're seeing that their actions cost money, cost time, more resources, things like that. And I think that goes a long ways in kind of the responsibility and accountability aspect that we're teaching these young people. They're having a good time with it, I think. That's been a unique challenge. 7 a.m. along with that, the temperature has been a real challenge as well. Uh-huh. But it's been a lot of fun. I think they really enjoy it. To be honest with you, on Mondays when we don't have class out here, they're really looking forward to coming out here, and they're now getting bored in the classroom because they really like this atmosphere.
Okay, now this piece here, you're gonna put these over the ends of the screws and turn that, and this piece here. For me, I'm up a little after 5 o'clock to get out here so that Jeff and I can get everything ready. So when the students show up, we have a brief meeting, and then we go to work. We have maybe 10 or 15 minutes to describe the work that we're going to be doing for the day. We go through as to how we're going to do it, what needs to be done, and the deadlines that we have to have completed, you know, for inspections or for subcontractors or whatever. It's real world experience. We're treating this as a job site. We expect these guys to be here and ready to work by 7 in the morning. If they're not here ready to go by 7, we have a little discussion with them that the expectation is this is their job, even though it is only a couple hours, 3 days a week. We expect them to treat it like it was a paid job.
Let's put a level front to back, if you could, just to see if we can determine whether this is off or not. Right now, we're down below the line a little bit. Yeah, that's good. Now put that other screw in there. You know, this is one of the toughest cabinets to hang because we had a lot of stuff we had to do to it. We had to cut the hole out for the vent. We had to put the wire in there to make sure it's level. And then once again, everything that we've done before with the screws is the same always, right? We've just followed the studs. I think the kids today did a great job. They listened good. They did exactly what was asked of them. And I think they learned a lot while they were going through it. Tried to take them step by step through some of the installation processes. I think that'll be a great thing for them for the rest of their life.
I think the project has been fantastic for my son and the boys from East DePere. They had to get up at 6:30 in the morning, and they worked here for a couple hours a day, but they learned how to hang trusses and how to put on siding and the roofing and how to put up cabinets and just real world things. They were very sad the last day that they had to go back to class and spend the first 2 hours of school in the classroom instead of back out here.
He really enjoyed it. Self-confidence, He's learning a skill that you can use the rest of your life. The son is outdoing the father now.
Having a great time out on this build, and there's no better way we could have done this than by giving back to the community. It's probably the best learning experience we can get.
It's getting close to Christmas. You think this is a good Christmas present for the family?
Would be a wonderful Christmas present, a home. I don't know if you can get much better than that, maybe a free car. Well, most high schoolers are building like little teeny popsicle houses or something like that. We're out here making a full-blown house. I'm just out here having a great time giving back, and I'm glad that I could be out here to help. I love it.
I actually just like coming out and helping out with the guys and putting it together. It's just a nice learning experience. And once we get rolling, we start getting everybody involved and start getting a lot of stuff done. You see a lot of production out of the guys that sometimes you don't see the most production out of. It's a different kind of class. It's a lot more hands-on orientated.
Well, it's a good way to help the community. We get out here, actually get build time instead of building a small shed at our school. We get to come out, work with real power tools. Everybody works together as a team. As you can see, we built just about the whole house. And we did this in a couple weeks. I mean, back in class, we wouldn't have even had a shed done by now. So I think it's really good. It's kind of hard getting up about then, but after a while you get used to it, but it's worth it. I wouldn't come to school that early, but glad to be out here working. This is getting out on the job site instead of sitting in a class looking at a diagram. This is the real thing.
Last week I took a picture of you and your dad. Tell me about that.
Yeah, my dad does rebuilding together, and he's worked on a few habitat builds, so he and I decided that it'd be good for him to come out, and I enjoyed it, and he helped a lot.
I have to say everything, just building it from the ground up every day, like coming there, just doing something new every day, learning something new.
It was a nice experience to like learn how everything in the house falls together. Just the whole process was pretty neat compared to average school.
I like doing the trim because you get to figure out like how to do the angles and with the copes and everything. And actually, you had to use your brain for that.
I kind of like doing the trim and all that stuff as much as I'd much rather frame, but I kind of like doing the trim because now when I walk into my own house or other people's house, I just notice all these little things that, well, this could have been done here and that could have been done there.
I don't know, I enjoyed learning all the little putsy stuff that not really people pay a lot of attention to. I really enjoyed the whole sheeting the roof and being up there.
I got a good experience, and I liked hanging cabinets.
Yeah?
Yeah, that wasn't too bad.
Enjoyed that?
Yeah, and then doing this stuff. I mean, it sounds like you got promoted in deer camp to do some work on the outhouse in the deer camp. One of the most important buildings at the camp.
Man, I wear a steel hard hat. I can ride rope, a hammer and paint, do things with my hands that most men can't. I can't get ahead no matter how hard I try. I'm getting really good at barely getting by. Got everything I own by the sweat of my brow. My four-wheel drive to my cowboy boots, I owe it all to my blue-collar roots. Feel like I'm working overtime on a runaway train. I got to bust loose from this ball and chain. I'm a hard-working man. I got it all on the line for a piece of the promised land. The only way to keep the fire going is to outrun the wind. Friday night. I like to party hard. I carry on with the Cadillac cutie. Spend my whole week's pay on some weekend beauty. Come Monday morning, I'm the first to arrive. I ain't nothing but business, y'all, from 9 to 5. I'm a hard working man. I got it all on the line for a piece of the promised land. And I'm burning my candle at both ends. About the only way to keep the fire going is to outrun the wind. I can't wait to get up in the morning and do it all over again. Well, I'm a hard living, hard working man.